Hello everyone and welcome back. I'm Brad and this is World of Warcraft Legion. I'm back on my hunter and it looks like one of our structures is finished. And there's a couple of extra quests that are ready, including one that's orange. And I'm curious if that's related to the broken shore itself or if it's related to my artifact, but we'll see. So currently the Mage Tower is active and it harnesses arcane energies quickly move Legion Fall forces throughout the Broken Isles and uncover challenging agents of the Legion. So we get a couple of bonuses here. One of them is Fell Treasures, and the other one is when you loot an item which grants artifact power in a raid or dungeon, there's a chance you'll receive a bonus artifact token. Okay, so that's not bad. So we still gotta work on these other two, the Command Center and the Nether Disruptor. But let's see what quests are now available. Well done, Sentry. In testament to the efforts of all the forces fighting here, we have come together to complete the construction of the Mage Tower. All that remains is for you to inspect our work and complete the construction. Okay, but the construction is done. I guess they might... Oh, I see. I have to actually physically complete it myself. I get it. Ooh. Fancy. Very elven. Our grand efforts have resulted in a boon which all can leverage in the coming days. Well done. I can now provide you with a boon that will grant you the benefit while the Mage Tower is activated. And it's knowledgeable. So there we go. I've got the boost on me right now. And it looks like this might be related to the Mage Tower. Let's see. Ooh, there's two quests here. Okay, I'm here to aid and advise you on the indirect threats that the Legion poses. These missions will be extremely difficult. Please be prepared. We will require nether shards to either breach the defenses or provide you with defenses to weather their horrific attacks. I will have some to spare occasionally, but not always. Please prepare accordingly. Fell Totems Fall. Okay, our high mountain contacted Navarog reports that Tugar Blood Totem has finally resurfaced. He sent a message crystal along with some instructions for me. I can teleport you to Navarog, and he will take you to Turgar's location, but there's one problem. Navarog requires additional magical power to fend off Turgar's fell magics. You will need some nether shards before you go. So I have to defeat this Turgar blood totem.
Turgar blood totem has resurfaced in High Mountain. With him is an immense worm, saturated with fell energy. We must put an end to him, along with that nasty pet of his, before they attack Thunder Totem. This will be no easy task.
Okay, so this looks like it's a very elite quest.
To your mages. Once you arrive here, we will enter Tugar's cavern and neutralize his threat.
Okay, and what's the other one? I have news from Archmage Carlin that Kirin Tor have found Rest Mage Sphere and can open a portal to his location. If you are ready to face him, I can have the mages here open the portal in the Twisting Nether.
Be careful.
Champion, our mages have pinpointed the location of Rest Mage Sphere within the Twisting Nether. We have little information to work from. But it seems he found a way to use the energy of the Twisting Nether to enhance his necromantic magic. Karam insisted on being sent in ahead of you, but I fear he cannot face this challenge alone. We will open a portal to his location, but can't hold it open long. Race must be stopped.
Okay, so it looks like this quest with Race doesn't involve nether shards.
Light
so
be with you.
Let's go there first.
Go with honor.
See what happens. This is designed for Marksman Hunter. Okay, I could switch to Marksman, but it's been a while since I played Marksman. So let's see what happens. I'll probably fail horribly.
You need something?
Here we go. Okay, this is totally creepy.
To follow me, brother. The Twisting Nether feeds my strength. I have become more powerful than you could ever imagine.
I cannot let you unleash your power upon Azeroth, Raist. If you do not yield, I will be forced to destroy you!
Well, brother against brother.
Destroy me? No, brother! Your blade will become my instrument!
Uh-oh.
What? What are you doing?
Oh, crap. Oh, crap. I have to beat both of them? Oh, no.
I obey.
I'm gonna keep kiting him and not let him get close. I should have stayed in Beast Hunter. It'd probably be easier. Oh crap. No. No! Oh! Holy crap, one hit and he killed me. Okay, it looks like I will need defenses to do those ones. And it's probably gonna take a while to do those as well. Now I know why they do marksmanship, because he would probably just one-shot my pets with every hit. Okay, let's do some of these quests down here. Looks like the goblin's got an available quest again. I wonder if that's another precious gem quest I have to seek out. He did say that, or she, it's a female goblin, she did say that she would have quests for me in the future. See what she has now. I have a feeling these are going to get more difficult.
Yeah, what do you want?
Hey, look for the rumored treasure in the soul ruins. I'm not a grave robber, but it is technically grave robbing if the treasure is sitting on a field of bones. It's not like it's buried or nothing. It's just going to sit this out. I'm just going to sit this out just in case. Okay. So it looks like it's dead center in in one of my previous videos, I called it a lake of bones. It's rather cool area. Let's see. Then there's Corrupt Kissels Destroyed. I did that in the previous video. Let's go after that item. I'm curious if it's going to lead to anything. I'm not sure if these wild goose chases this female goblin's sending me on is going to lead to anything cool. Like, will one of these items eventually be, like, an amazing thing, or is it all going to be a waste of time? It would be typical for goblins to do that to me. Oh, Doombringer. Doombringer might be the Fell Infernal. We'll see. Not sure yet. Alright, I'm gonna have to fight my way through this. Don't really have much choice.
I don't have a target.
Bell Totem Necromancer. Somebody's attacking this Emberfire guy, so I'm gonna help out. I know if one of those ground target things hit me, I die instantly. So as simple as this looks, it's not quite so simple. guy isn't even the boss. He's just a fell infernal. Oh. Wow. That was crazy. Oh, so there is the boss. The boss that's on my map, he's up there on that hill. I'm not sure how to get up there, though. Okay, I'll worry about that later. I've got to find the treasure key. Whatever that means.
I'm out of range.
Exactly sure what I'm looking for. It could be on a corpse or on an enemy, but it doesn't seem to be. I thought it might be a treasure like lying in the ground, but even then I don't see it. Oh, wait a sec. What's this? Ah, there he is. You little punk. So I did find it, but that stupid little troll stole it. Okay, so I'll go back after I try to get up to this boss. Not exactly sure how I'm gonna get up there. Like, do you have to fly, or is there a path? Not sure. Do I have to jump on these rocks? They look a little high to jump on. Yeah, those are too high to jump on, so... No path there. People are getting up there, but I don't know how they're getting up there. And I don't see any... Like, I've been through here a bunch of times, and I haven't seen any paths to run up. Either I'm totally missing them, or it's further out. Aha, here's the path. Maybe this is it. Yep, it is. Oh, look at all the room they give. Okay, this is a lot of room for this guy. He is back. A couple of warlocks here.
I will leave my cinders.
We should be able to kill him. We've got my two pets and the warlock demons. Should be good. If he doesn't have any, like, killer abilities that could one-shot us. Oops. I'm gonna get a bit more distance from this guy. I don't trust him. Oh, that's a Shadow Bolt volley. It's gonna hit everyone around him. We got him. He's gonna die. Okay, so we're good with that. Let me feed up a little bit. All right, let's continue. We've got Lady Eldrath is back, but there's also these pulsating gems and the Fellborn Punishers now. So those weren't available the last time I was killing Lady LSN. But I'm going to go over and check. Since it's right here, I'm going to check, see what that is. It looks like we just, it looks like it's just a standard kill quest. But it also awards 25 war supplies, so I will take it. You only need 100 to put towards an upgrade to our Legion base. So, or our, I guess we're just a resistance faction.
The Fellborn were given gems of insidious power from the Legion.
I'm
rip
just
these
mortals up.
From their hands and destroy them. The lives of these elves are now forfeit.
There we go. It looks like I'm gonna have to fight my way down.
Feel the might of the Shaldarai! The Shaldarai will rule this world!
Oh, those guys have little AoEs. That's really aggravating.
I need a target.
Wow, they're respawning so fast. I'm not surprised there's so many players up here doing this quest. Oh! That guy has three. Move, move, move. He's got two guards with him. Rather not deal with them. The shrine was corrupted by the Legion. Actually, let's go after him. Why not? Oh, wait. I've got to eat again. I've never taken this much damage in a long time. The Broken Shore is definitely more difficult with the world quests than the regular Isle. Maybe because they're new, or we just have to figure out their abilities. But, it could be very challenging. Let's send them ahead.
It's too far away.
Death is certain.
So it looks like the gems they drop are seemingly low drop items. I've gotten two and I've killed about probably 15 of them. It's probably less, but it seems like I've killed at least 15 of them.
Something first.
Oh, ran right at me.
Target.
Technically, I don't have to go all the way in, but if I want to kill Lady Elisande, I have to. Loot. No, I've got to attack her.
Thank you.
Oh, it's Eldra. Eldra, I guess? Lady Eldra? So basically, she used to be a Nightborn, but she got corrupted and became this creature. Okay, looks like I got some new gloves. The gloves I'm wearing are 860s, so I may not even need to use these. Okay, so we completed two quests in no time. Now we have to fight our way out. I guess I could fly out. Yeah, let's do that instead of getting caught in all of the respawns. It'll take like friggin' 5 minutes to get out of here at this rate. There we go. Now let's see. Oh, I only got 3 of the 5 pulsating gems. What am I doing? Oh, that's okay. I can just kill the guys up here and get them. I'll just stay up here so I don't go too far in. There we go, so I'll just kill these guys. One more.
I don't have a target.
Oh, really? There's one guy left. And they didn't give me the drop.
Feel the might of the shoulder eye.
I need to target something first.
Please give me it. Please give me it.
Closer.
Yes, got it.
The fell energies inside those crystals dissipated upon their destruction. Consider their threat neutralized.
Kind of like that Illidan's back on our side. Well, I think he's back on our side. It's kind of cool. Like, it was all a misunderstanding sort of thing. But not really, but kinda. There is, Duty's End. Lay the Fallen to rest. And it is a brown dragon quest, whatever that means. Let's go over and see. That's the first time I've seen that icon on this aisle. Like, I've seen the dragon icons before, just, not the brown one. Could be in a cave. Not sure. I may be going the wrong way, but I can jump across like I normally do. Whee! Ouch. Okay, it looks like he's just up the hill here.
Torn are defiling the bodies of the fallen. No one deserves this fate. Lay them to rest. Champion.
Oh, wow.
I need to target something first.
Why do I have to find a group? I could fight these guys solo. They're elites, but I should be able to beat them. Unless there's a boss at the end. Oh, if there's a boss after this, it's gonna suck.
I need a target.
Oh, he's a mage. Can't handle them on his own, so he's like dragging them towards me.
I need a target.
What is this? It's like a staff on the ground.
I need to target something first.
It's nice that they offer the group option, but I'm fine without a group. Don't really need to do anything. Tiny little goblin had a knockback. Just a percentage completion quest, which is good.
I don't have a target.
Let's get out of here. I don't care which way I go, just as long as I get away from here. There's too many enemies. There we go. Defeat Sissix, that's just a pet battle quest. Not gonna bother with that. There is the corrupted Bonebreaker. He's up the mountain though, I believe. Yeah, we're gonna have to go up the mountain and come back down. It would have been better if I just stayed up where I was and ran it. We'll see if I can reach them in roughly the 30-minute mark. And if there's somebody already fighting them, we'll just finish off there. Otherwise, I have a feeling people will be fighting him, but if they're not, I'm gonna have to wait, which will take too long for the video. Alright, we're back, and I'm just coming up to the boss now. It looks like people are already attacking him, so I'm just gonna join in. Just like that, we're done. A lot of players fighting these guys makes it so easy to do these. They're a little bit anticlimactic, but it's better to have someone there helping me out than doing it all alone. But thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. If you like this video, please hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.